So let's talk about planting kale. Kale is one of the most nutrient-dense food on the planet. It's an excellent source of antioxidants and rich source of vitamins and minerals that prevent certain illness. If you're planting during cool season, make sure the plant can get a full sun. While if you're growing during warmer temperature, you can also plant it in a partial shade area. Beets, celery, cucumbers, herbs, onions, spinach, chard, and potatoes are best companion plants for kale, while it doesn't grow well with beans, strawberries, or tomatoes. In my case, I always put it in a separate container or separate pots because I like it separated. So the method of planting kale is best when you transplant it. Make sure to sow it 1/4 to 1/2 inch or even deeper, like an inch, into a well-drained light soil pot. Or you can put it in a temporary small pot first, then transplant it into a bigger pot as it grows. When planting in a bigger pot, can have it 30 cm by 30 cm apart to make the growing faster. Mostly germination comes in 3 to 5 days. Transplanting will follow after 10 to 15 days. You can transplant it in a bigger pot or in its permanent container. It matures around 50 to 75 days after transplanting, which means it will be ready for harvest. It is important to keep kale well watered and make sure to feed it with organic fertilizers such as compost or worm tea. You can side dress those fertilizer 8 to 10 days after transplanting, and make sure, or it is recommended, to put fertilizer after every harvest. You can find cabbage worms chewed holes in those leaves, while fruit flies and aphids can also be seen. You can easily get rid of those pests with some organic pesticide. You can harvest kale when the size of the leaves are about the size of your hand, but there are some varieties that it won't. The leaves are smaller, so you have to note the dates or the days. So usually 50 to 55 days after planting, you can now harvest it. Then concurrent harvest every 3 weeks. You can actually harvest multiple times with kale. You can harvest all those big leaves, but make sure to leave at least 2 leaves and buds for regrowth.